In other news, the Philippine Supreme Court affirms the junking of graft charges against former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo over the NBN-ZTE telecommunications deal. The country's top court dismissed the petition filed to contest the ruling for lack of merit. In 2016, the anti-graft court dismissed the graft charges against Arroyo after prosecutors allegedly failed to establish her alleged interest in the NBN-ZTE contract. They added that the prosecution supposedly failed to prove the value of the lunch and golf game that Arroyo supposedly attended in China around the time of the negotiations of that deal. Arroyo was accused of violating the anti-graft law for approving the allegedly anomalous contract. She scrapped the deal in 2007 after allegations of overpricing and bribery surfaced. Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana supports the appointment of a controversial army officer as the spokesman of the Philippines' anti-communist task force. Lorenzana insists that President Duterte did not violate any law when he appointed Lieutenant General Antonio Parlade to speak for the national task force to end the local communist armed conflict.
Kami ang nagkapatupad niyan. Yung ibang mga ahensya ng gobyerno ay support lang sa amin yan. Yung DPWH, lahat na DOE, DOSWD, support lang yan sa main effort. And the main effort is being led by the PNP and the AFP. And General Parlade is part of the AFP. And so his expertise has been being utilized as a spokesman of the NTFL-LCAC. So wala akong makikitang violation of the Constitution.
Senators earlier recommended that Parlade be removed as the task force's spokesman. Senator Panfilo Lacson believes that Parlade's appointment violated a constitutional ban on active duty military officers in civilian positions in the government.